before the album.
Hammer,
here come the hammer. All that that was going on during this time.
Yeah,
and he was that with the pants and everything.
Yeah, but this is when
he had hits.
But remember, this is when he started getting the flack because he bought the helicopter for Oakland PD and he bought the battle ram and all that stuff.
Yeah. Yeah, we on Boss Talk 101. Yeah, we gonna talk.
No, that's, well, I'll be honest with you. When we signed, we went down to audition in front of Hammer because we were like, okay, Hammer wants us to come down. So he had a van come. We got in there.
This was before the album. Hammer, here come the Hammer. All that, that was going on during this time.
Yeah.
And he was that with the pants and everything.
Yeah, but this is when
Hammer, he had hits.
But remember, this is when he started getting the flack because he bought the helicopter for Oakland PD and he bought the battle ram and all that stuff.
Yeah.
So he had to change his image. And what was sad was that all the stuff that Hammer tried to prevent, like the image, all the rappers do now. So it's like, it's funny, like he was the architect for all that. All that product. And I mean, think about it. I got toothpaste, I have a Hammer Time toothpaste. I have a Hammer Time game. You know what I'm saying?
He did everything.
He did that before everyone else. And what happened with black people is that they mocked him and talked about him and didn't understand that. Because a lot of people don't know this. Hammer, at one time, was one of the largest black talent agents. He had Salt and Pepper. He had Heavy D. He had Ralph Tresvant. He had, I'm thinking about it, 357. He had Special Generation. He had, think about it, Uncle whatever. He had all those groups, and they were under his management. Him and his brother, Louis Burrell. They were all under his management. We had tons. I mean, a lot of people don't know this, but Ralph used to live in Fremont, California. When he did his albums, he was under us as well. A lot of people don't know that. Hammer really.
Y'all the one broke up New Edition.
No.
Yeah, let's just be real about it.
New Edition broke up. New Edition.
Why is Ralph over there? Man. You didn't say Mike, Ronnie, Bobby, and Ricky was over there. You say Ralph was over there. Yeah. And that makes me understand that Ralph had disconnected for some kind of reason. Yeah, he was over here talking about other things.
Well, you know what? And I like that the story kind of told his story.
Yeah, I seen that.
Because I'll be honest with you.
Was he lying on there?
I remember when Ralph lived in Fremont with his wife, and I remember him coming down to the studio playing Sensitivity. I remember when he first.
They all was bad. Out. That was too much talent in one group. That's why they was tripping.
Well, you know what? I'm gonna tell you what happened with my group. My group got to the point where it was even hard to take pictures for magazines because everybody wanted their position. I'm over here. I want to be over here. I want to do this. A lot of pictures, you'll see that I'm kind of in the back or I'm turned away because we're moving. Because they always tell you, "Oh, move! Yeah, I'll move this way." And I always got pushed. I always got pushed to, like, make sure this Negro don't get to the front. and they might say, "Oh, Deuce, that's not true," but that is true. And then, you know, and so it got to the point where people really start tripping about the money, like who's getting extra money, who's getting extra perks. I'll be honest with you. There was a group that Madonna had, I think my people, YMV.
Mm-hmm.
Some people are going to say, "Oh, well, Deuce is the reason why the group broke up." I am not the reason the group broke up.
Let's get it straight.
I'm not. But I will tell you what did happen. This is on working on my reality to let people know what's really going on. I met a guy from the group IMV. We were in Savannah, Georgia doing a show. And he comes up to me. And, you know, and this is the reason why I believe that we need to really teach the youngsters about business. Don't just get in the game and just get in the game.
Mm-hmm.
Take a course. Learn about business because it's business.
Exactly.
I mean, we have talent, but it's also business. To them, they see the dollars. Cha-ching, cha-ching. And he said to me, "What's in your rider?" And I said, "Rider? What the hell's a rider?" Now, I got the number one song in the country right now, and I don't know what a rider is. And he goes, like, "What do you want in your backstage? Like, do you have M&Ms? Do you have, you know, candy bars? Or, you know, like, what do you want them to do?" And I said, "I don't know. Whatever they put back there." He goes, "Well, do you want your money up front or do you come and, you know, like get money now and you get the rest of the money?"
"Sure,
when
give
you get
me my
there.
Money up front."
And I was like, "Well, I don't take care of that. Him, the office does that." And he's like, "What? You let the office do that for you?" And I've always been blessed in my life. God's always brought people in my life.
Hey, man. All,
I'll be honest with you.
Listen, see, man. I'm
going to tell you this one thing. What happened is that he took me to Tower Books and bought me this book called All You Need to Know About the Music Business. And the one that Kashif, All About the Music Business by Kashif.
Mm-hmm.
And Donald Passman, the All About the Music Business. And he said, "Look, take these two books and I want you to start reading them." And I started reading them. By the time I got to Omaha, Nebraska, I was pissed. I was like, "I'm getting screwed over."
Oh, my God.
And so I knew that nobody could mimic me. No one could do my parts. And so I told Hammer one night, I was in the hotel, I said, I ain't going on stage. And he said, no, you got to go. What do you mean you ain't going on stage? I'm not going on stage. I said, I got asthma. I ain't got no health care. I could die. I'm in the Great Plains. You know, I got asthma. I got grass all over the place. If I get sick, who going to take care of me? I ain't got, you know what I'm saying? I have nothing to fall back on. I said, I'm not going. And he was like, Deuce, just go on stage. Just do this show. And when you get back, we're going to talk. We're going to talk. He always do that. We're going to talk.
Yeah, we on Boss Talk 101. Yeah, we gonna talk.